here we've got a main tank of 5.4 million litres with dozens of small aquariums around that. The overall project value is about 180 million US, and we're using George Fisher pipe and fittings here exclusively.
George Fisher is a Swiss-based company. It was founded in 1802, so it's over 200 years old. It has three major corporation or corporate groups. One is automotive, one is machine tools, and one is piping systems.
Large-scale oceanarium construction is our core business. We've diversified into all aspects of that, including acrylic supply and install, rockwork and scenery, waterproofing and life support systems. Started in 2002, and you know, in the last few years we've grown to be one of the largest aquarium companies in the world.
George Fisher is in many fields in piping systems. So wherever you transport or convey any liquid and measure it, that's where we are. So it can go into utility projects like waterworks, mining, chemical plants, water plants.
We really haven't been in negotiations with George Fisher. It's just been an ongoing relationship ever since we've started. We use them for all their piping fittings.
In 2008, we were actually approached. John and the project managers for AAT were looking for a piping system in PVC up to 400 mil, and we actually had the system to provide it.
We've been using exclusively George Fisher pipe and fittings because it is it's a well-known brand, and it also has a complete range for what we need. So it's a one-stop shop. We don't need to buy valve and pipe and fittings from different companies. It's a one-stop shop, and it's also very well recognised in the world, so the relationship's been very useful for us.
Okay, now we're moving into the main plant room. There's 18 2.4 metre high rate sand filters in this room, returning water back to the main aquarium.
The relationship's been established over a decade now with the construction of the Guangzhou Oceanarium, and then it's been progressive through the last decade with the Shanghai Ocean Aquarium and a multitude of smaller oceanariums around the world to the construction of Ocean Park here in Hong Kong.
I have to say, I guess our local representative in Queensland did a very good job to get to know AAT from a very early start, when John Langmead, the owner, was actually project manager in Shanghai, and they built the aquarium that was about 8 years ago. And then John went on his own with the company AAT, Advanced Aquarium Technologies. And I guess from then on we got to know each other, so the relationship developed over time.
I've been working with Advanced Aquarium Technologies since about 1999, when they were formerly called Living Ocean International. And we've, over the years, put together a PVC piping system actually fit for purpose for the aquarium market.
It's a very important relationship that we have, and it's helped our business to grow. Our association with George Fisher has really, really helped our business grow. The pipe and fittings are very well known, so it's not as if we're bringing brand names into Europe or Asia that aren't well known. The George Fisher piping system is very well known.
I think it's the fact that we have so many products that we can draw from so many various factories worldwide and manufacturing facilities. We actually have five different standards of PVCU piping systems, including valves, that we can actually use to incorporate into the AAT system.
From the sales side, they support us in the factory, and they support us out in construction, out on the field. The way they do that is they register the feedback from the installers like ourselves, and they adapt to that. George Fisher has assisted to adapt a specialised system just for oceanariums.
The relationship between George Fisher and AAT is very strong because we've been working together for so long. We've actually adapted and evolved the PVC piping system to suit both companies.
As an installer, they're looking for the feedback from us to develop their product.
Hong Kong, there's approximately about 4 kilometres of plastic piping systems. Like I said, hundreds of valves, thousands of bore valves, and thousands of different types of fittings. We've supplied a George Fisher UPVC Schedule 80 piping system in 6-inch, incorporated with our vanstone flanges for easy assembly, with our new 563 valves for long life applications, all actuated electrically to 240 volts. We'll be right back. we're currently using what we call the 567 butterfly valve. It's a double eccentric design, so it's a different operating principle to any other valve on the market, that when the disc is in the open position, it doesn't have any contact with the seal or the body of the valve. That increases the service life. It also enhances safety. It allows no particle buildup between the disc and the seal in the open position. It actually washes all the particles away. There's not a lot of companies worldwide that can offer a fully pressurated PVC system up to 400 millimetres.
I think it's also our global reach, because wherever AAT goes, they are most probably with a subsidiary and give it local support.
With the George Fisher range, we can go for different countries. We can be in metric or imperial or a combination of both. And that gives us an opportunity for a complete range to change and adapt for each country that we're in.
Okay, this is our skid-mounted filtration equipment. Each aquarium, there's 17 aquariums on this project, and each aquarium has one of these skid-mounted units. So this is factory tested, assembled and tested before it's sent to site, and commissioned with a program and the like.
The skids are made in Australia. For this project in Hong Kong, there's 17 skids in total for 17 smaller aquariums. What we consider a small aquarium is anything between 5 and 20 cubic metres. Being off-site, it gives us an opportunity to save time whilst on-site. Also gives us opportunity in the workshop environment to create and build these skids and also pre-test them off-site, completely retest them, debug the codes, run the pumps up, get the flow rate sorted. Each one of the skids is specifically designed for each water quality and environment, and simply just built off-site. We call it a skid, just gives us an opportunity to spend more time in a workshop environment to create it.
I think with AAT is a good example of working in the relationship and really developing an understanding, because also AAT helped us to, I guess, improve our product range, look into certain applications a bit more closer, and come up with certain solutions that we haven't had before.
It's the highest of quality. I mean, I've visited the factory and it's incredible. If anyone saw the amount of R&D and also the amount of testing and quality assurance that goes into the product, it's a really, really incredible brand.
This is the main foam fractionator room. There's a total of 24 foam fractionators, 12 on either side of the plenum. This is basically the heart of the oceanarium.
Very, very competent installer, and Hong Kong's a fairly good example. A very pristine installation, very well supported and very well installed.
I think John is very open with us. I think that's really important in a relationship, even if it's a business relationship. When you get to know each other, first of all, the chemistry has to be right too. We get along also personally very well. It's also the trust you actually build up. So John will tell us exactly where we need to be within the price. There's no haggling. It really is about, look, this is what we do, this is what we need from you, can you go there? And we know where you have to be. So I think it really is the trust and the openness we have with each other that helps us to get over the line with these jobs.
It's just a quality product. It's second to no other product in the world. The quality is one aspect. The support that we get from George Fisher in developing their products further in oceanarium's environments is second to none.
Well, Bruno, above us is the main aquarium, 5.4 million litres of water, and these are the foam fractionator pumps. The suction there, water travelling at 170 litres a second by these six main discharge pumps up to the fractionators on the third floor.
It's a very interesting project. It's massive, but it always amazes me that a relatively small company like AAT still is, even they grew a lot, how they can manage a job like that. And it shows just the professionalism of this company. They really know what they're doing. And we are very proud to be associated with them.
We'd like to be associated with such a high quality brand that we believe that's the market that we're shooting for, and that's where AAT sees itself as well. So to be aligned with George Fisher's, very useful.